Welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a hot little minute. Definitely been going through lots of major life changes and beautiful new beginnings and scary, crazy endings and cyclical stuff. And so while my energy was recalibrating, I didn't want to come on and do any readings, but I'm still working with my private clients, and I'm in a much better space to provide the messaging to y'all. And I wanted to do a pick a pile reading. So you've got three piles here to choose from. The first pile has angel light on it. The second pile, desert rose. And the third pile, blood quartz. These are some beautiful stones. So take a second here to really think about which pile you're choosing, and then we'll get started. Please feel free to like, comment, share, subscribe this video. Help me get the word out, guys, so that we can change the vibrations together. All right, so if you pick pile one, you picked angelite. Angelite is a beautiful stone of self-love and calling in the love of the angels. It's a nice blue stone. This is a tumbled angelite. I'm being compelled to grab you an angelite that is raw, occurs raw. Here's another angelite stone. Feel those vibrations. They are so yummy. Indeed they are. So we'll keep this here for your reading. Just kind of bring that energy in. Wow. Okay, so somebody who picked pile one right now is feeling a little upside down when it comes to their finances. You could be dealing with a Gemini or an Aquarius in regards to these finances. Could be your boss. The number five could be relevant to you guys as well too, but I'm picking up there's definite worry around finances and the fact that you feel as if you're owed something financially, and it's definitely giving you mental anguish. And the person that you're dealing with, again, could be an air sign or a water sign, Gemini, Aquarius. I'm definitely getting Aquarius energy for you guys, and this person is not really acting in the way you expected them to. But I want you to look at the bigger picture here, because your hard work is paying off, but maybe not in the way that you originally saw it paying off, if that makes sense. To me, it does. It's like, it goes back to the idea of like, this isn't happening to me, it's happening for me. It goes back to sometimes the universe takes things out of our way that we're not capable of doing ourselves so that we can have better things fall into place. Now, in your love life, if you're not already attached, keep an open mind, because your soulmate might differ from your usual type and expectations. And you really do attract the love that you're looking for by enjoying your moments fully. And it goes back to what this card is saying, is that you can accept yourself as a vibrational being. Once you accept yourself as a vibrational being who attracts all things that come into your experience, once you understand the correlation between that, what you're thinking and feeling is what you're gonna receive. You'll get the keys as soon as you figure that out to get whatever you want, and you can be wherever you want on all subjects. So it's law of attraction, it's manifestation, and keeping your vibrations high so that you can actually receive what it is that you've been so hardly working on that's gonna pay off. I want you to be cautioned, and so does Angel Bridget. Look deeper into the situation before proceeding further. So I'm hearing that you guys tend to like pop off instead of like sitting back and waiting to see like how things play out. I want you guys to let the universe do its thing and hand you what you're supposed to get. It shouldn't be hard. it's a message for me too. Like, you shouldn't, it shouldn't be hard. It should flow. Angel Maya, schooling, study, and education help your life's purpose and personal growth at this time. The angels are going to guide you and help you through the process. So if some of you guys are thinking about going back to school, or maybe taking some self-help type courses or going back to the gym, the angels are with you and they're going to help you. And then I was going to say, this is somebody who's going through a spiritual awakening too. Angel Indriel, you're a light worker. God needs you to shine your divine light and love like an angel. Angel light. And that's what you pulled? That's so weird. I love that. Upon the earth and all of its inhabitants. So if you pull pile one and you feel as if you are losing your mind because you're having this empathic connection to people, the energies are driving you crazy. The reason this is all happening is because you're building your soul tree. So this is saying for you to go out and get grounded, hug a tree, literally go hug a tree, sit under a tree, ask the tree for the answers. Sounds so hippy dippy, but they do, they tell us things. and I think the message you're gonna get is this tree of life type mentality, Adam, Eve, the snake, the beginning of it all, creation. And you'll start realizing that what's been happening is the universe has been shaking up your life so that you can start receiving what your actual soul's purpose is, which I believe that is in healing. So if you guys are thinking about going back to med school, I just heard, or going to school for medicine or some sort of healing, you're on the right track. If you want more information, feel free to message me. We can schedule a private reading around that if you pick pile one for more information. I certainly do light worker coaching as well too. Moving on to pile two at 7 minutes and 3 seconds. 10 completion. Desert Rose. If you pick this, it's basically from selenite. It brings peace, but it is raw occurring like this, and it is just gorgeous. It looks like these little crystallines. All this is divine knowledge, but holding it does bring you tranquility. So whoever picked this pile is probably searching for some tranquility in their life. Yeah. 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 Change, change, change. Yeah, someone's holding on to who they used to be. Okay. Love is good, though. Love is good. Great. So a lot of these cards were upside down, so I'm just going to put them right side up because if they're all upside down, then to me it's just looking at it a different way. Or maybe it's a sign for the universe that these cards aren't for me. So someone's been in the hanged man energy, waiting for some sort of cosmic and karmic justice. And that's why you've needed that rock, that peace, because you have had no peace waiting on what you believe to be your justice. And it's keeping you not moving forward, and it's actually keeping you doing all of the work and bearing the brunt of the entire situation all by yourself. And with this Seven of Swords, like, the energy is all mental. Like, you're the one creating the anguish. I don't necessarily feel as if I think that you're creating the stress in your own life. Like, the hanged, stuck energy is the problem in itself. Like, you need to make a choice. Being stuck is like, no, that's a no. That's a solid no for me, like, one or the other. And, like, that's why you can't get this justice. Like, it's coming, but you're not able to call it in because you're sitting in this, like, hung energy doing all the work by yourself and being, like, mentally, like, messed up about it. And you could be dealing with an Aries as well here. And the number seven could be relevant to you as well, too. But you do have the Two of Cups. So love is solid. The situation is solid. Could be with a Cancer or with a Aries. As well, the number two could be relevant, and the planet Pluto that just went into retrograde, by the way. So things are coming back around, but this could be the one. You've already met the romantic partner that you seek. So when it comes to love, you've already found your forever, your soulmate, your marriage. So these cards to me I feel like it's baby's father and child support stuff, and or a court case that you're waiting on finances to come in, and or both. But somebody is allowing their past to hold them back. Like, you're not moving forward. Like, clearly you're not moving anywhere because you pulled the hangman and this transformation card where you need to do something. Like, you cannot be stuck. I'm so angry at you guys right now, energetically, not for real. But I know that you feel like you don't have the answers, but they're coming. The answers that you seek are coming and they're gonna be clear, but you have to be in belief that they're A, gonna come, and then B, that you're deserving of them. The Angel Mystique says, keep charging ahead and don't take no for an answer. Expect miraculous solutions to appear. And they do every freaking time. God is good, I say. Yvonne, you have a special bond with animals. Your pets on earth and in heaven are watched over by angels, and they are your angels, just so you know. You have spirit and animals. I'm seeing so many dogs over there energetically for the collective. Like, the dogs are barking. Also, that's, somebody needs to go get a pedicure as well. I'm rediscovering the art of allowing my natural well-being. I have come to the realization that I know people that actually prefer their lives messy and chaotic because they don't know how to function outside of the chaos. Guess what? Just choose to be happy. It's that simple. Don't let anybody steal your joy. We call this discipline the art of allowing. It's the art of allowing the well-being, which makes up every particle of that which you are and that which you come from, by continuing to flow through you as you just continue to be and be happy. Your choice every single day, pile two, how you want to feel. All right, pile three at 12 minutes and 4 seconds. Blood quartz. So this is someone who's looking for protection. This is a great stone for grounding and protection and working on your root chakra. Any sex type traumas, demons, it's great for that. Any sort of relationship clearing, cleansing, it's great for that too. Protection from any sort of yuck and muck. Oof. Now I know why this person needed it. Oof. Oof. You guys are now in an energy where you're done resting and relaxing. Like, you're over that whole, like, recuperating, recharging. You're out and about celebrating. And you've pulled the Hierophant. So, like, you're gonna get, people are starting to see you as wifey material or husband material. But very slowly, there is a night, an air sign potentially, or a water sign, with this being the Chariot coming right after, but in reverse. So it's like someone is taking their sweet ass time, but they are coming in because they see that either, this is not a lot of fire energy, so this is the Nine of Rods. It's either Leo, Sagittarius, the number 9. Two 9s on the board, actually. So angel number 99 is a Googleable thing for you guys. There's a message there. I believe it to be that it's like you're coming to, things are coming to an end. I'm almost positive. Could be dealing with a Gemini and Aquarius, or a Leo and a Sagittarius, because you've got the 9 of Rods and the 9 of Coins. So, like, something is coming to an end, and I feel like it's this period of resting and relaxing. Like, you know who you are, you're the star, and you pulled the Hierophant twice. So you're getting engaged, you're being seen as, like, someone's forever. That's great. There's this new enlightenment about you that is making you be very flirtatious. I think that you're very attractive out there, celebrating. This is a very single, was single, like the Hierophant twice, like someone's getting wifed up or married soon. Bring love into the situation because a new romantic cycle is beginning and luck is on your side with the new moon in Sagittarius. A lot of Sagittarius energy on the board, actually. Sagittarius, Aquarius are probably the two strongest on the board. I've seen both of them twice. Angel Astara, you deserve the best. Reach for the stars of your dreams and desires and don't compromise. What this means is like not settling. Like that's why you waited so long. Oh, wow. And you pulled Archangel Michael. God bless Archangel Michael. Oh, also like my favorite Archangel after Uriel. I'm with you, giving you the courage to make life changes that will help you work on your divine life purpose. Yeah, that's great. And then Rochelle, as you honor and follow the guidance of your heart, prosperity is coming to you now. So it's like, it's almost like reaffirming that as long as you do what's in your heart and what you feel is guided by spirit and God and it's authentic and you're not harming anybody, you're gonna get your prosperity because good things happen to good people. And then you also pulled, I'm standing on the leading edge of thought. So you're a forward thinker if you pick pile three. I usually would pick pile three. Just as all of your experiences from the time of your birth into your physical body until now has culminated into who you are, all that has ever been experienced by all that has ever culminated into what you are experiencing in the physical experience right now on the planet Earth. So all things from the past lives, other realms, plus everything we've experienced here is happening right now. And actually my friend Caitlin and I at 5 a.m. this morning, we're sitting outside under the moon talking about that exact thing, that we are perfectly perfect in this moment. It is supposed to be. So enjoy the ride and try to learn as much as you can from it and just be a good human, guys. We have to raise the planet's vibration. Most of you guys are parents out there. You know, at my age, I should have had children. I'm almost happy I didn't because it's a very, very strange time. But if you care about your babies, like, be good people, because karma passes down. And I can't want to fix the planet enough for your kids, you know? Maybe my future babies too, but. Yo, that's like some really serious meditation music, like right on cue, right? Like whatever. So yes, please like, share, comment, and subscribe. Remember, there's mad retrogrades right now. If you feel weird, you're so just part of us all. We're all doing it. We're all interconnected. We're all one. I am you. You are me. I am no better than you. You are no better than me. Everything that is you is me. And I love you because I love me. And I support you because I support me. And as long as you don't harm me, I only have love to give thee. So God bless, everybody. One love. Please like, share, comment, subscribe.